What's up, guys? So, I got a few comments on the build video saying, does your build kill Uber Lilith? Well, yes it does. I have two Uber Lilith kills that I'm going to show out of the 19 that I've done in Season 1. And we only have to swap a few things from the original in-game build to make it happen. The swaps are very small and easy to do, and once you're done with Uber Lilith, you can swap right back to the original build and get back into pushing those high nightmare sigils. So on the second kill, I'm going to do a walkthrough to explain how to achieve your Uber Lilith kill. So let's get into it. As we start the fight, notice how I stay in the same spot until we phase her. The reason is I want to keep our intercom proc for the 30% increased damage. So at the start of the fight, we are looking for 4 corpses to explode. So when the burst window comes, we can proc our CT and explode the last corpse to proc our Flesh Eater for max burst. So once you get her down to a little bit below quarter of life, we're going to use the corpse in the middle of the room to proc CT and corpse explosion to start our burst window. Then we'll clean up the adds. She will fly up and do a pentagram wave. We're going to blood mist this. Once you're safe, cancel the blood mist early and give her a few bone spheres to phase her. In the second phase, notice where I'm standing. It's the perfect distance for our returning splinters not to travel too far behind her and give us instant damage. And remember, stay still for that intercom to proc. So we'll proc our 4 corpses, and as soon as we proc our 4 corpses, we're going to use that corpse closest to her. When her second wing spawns, we're going to hit CT, corpse explosion, bone storm, and burst. So here she's going to darken one side of the floor and move to the other and draw a line in the middle. You want to be on the other side of the line out of the darkness. As soon as the darkness goes away, we'll move back to the original point. Now she's going to do this 2 more times to cut off 2 more sections of the platform. Just rinse and repeat. So as the last platform explodes, move back to the center and she'll teleport in, and she should be about dead, and then you can get your kill. Alright, let's look at some of the changes that we made to make this happen. So first we'll go into the Paragon board and we're going to swap Control for Imbiber. And then we'll take all the intel nodes out and swap them for willpower. Then we'll go into our skill tree and we're going to take that 1 point out of Decrepify and put that into Inspiring Leader. And then we'll swap our intercom for Edge Masters. And make sure you also put your splintering back on in place of the Decrepify. So you can see you can swap back and forth very easily to do High Nightmare Dungeons and Uber Lilith. So, as usual guys, if you liked the video, please like, share, and subscribe. And we'll see you in the next one.